Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about diastasis recti, DR for short. So throughout this whole video, I'm going to probably be saying DR instead of diastasis recti, but I'm just letting you guys know right now what exactly DR is. But in today's video, we're going to be talking about diastasis recti, what it is for those of you who don't know what it is, how I've been dealing with my DR, what I'm doing for my DR, and what programs, exercises, my diet, and all that good stuff we are going to be talking about in this video. If you guys are interested and want to know about everything that I've been doing fitness wise and especially for my core, this is the video for you. So let's go ahead and get straight to the video. The first things first, I did post a video recently on my Instagram. If you guys don't have an Instagram or don't follow me on Instagram, I'm going to post a picture right here. I posted this picture on Instagram and I got a lot of comments in regards to what exactly I did in this picture. These two pictures are a month apart, and the left picture I took last month, and then the right picture is what I took currently this month. So I took this picture because I wanted to share with you guys what I've accomplished during my 1 month of working out consistently and doing everything right. I'm not saying everything was right, but I did stay consistent with my diet, and I did stay consistent with my exercises, especially for my core. Before I even go deeper into this video, I want to talk quickly about diastasis recti, what exactly it is. And before I even start this video, I want to put a disclaimer out there. I am no means a physical therapist, and I'm not a doctor. So if you guys are feeling any pain or anything that's regarding your stomach or anything down there, please consult your doctor. This video is just to inform you of what my journey and what I've gone through with my entire experience after having kids. So this is, just had to put that out there just in case you guys are like, wait, Sam, and then you start asking me a whole bunch of questions. I don't know, okay? I'm just sharing with you guys my personal experience, and whatever you gain from my personal experience, you can take that to your doctor and see what works for you. So I'm not saying to just do everything I did. You need to consult your doctor because that's safe, okay? So that, yeah, I just wanted to put that out there, okay guys? First things first, a lot of the comments that I was getting from that post that I posted was, what exactly is DR? Now, really quickly, if you follow me or have been following my journey, you probably know what diastasis recti is, DR. And DR is pretty much abdominal separation. You don't have to have kids to necessarily have diastasis recti. You can have diastasis recti even now. Like, for example, my brother, he obviously is a male, but he does have ab separation. So he kind of has like DR going on because I can see that he has like the abdominal separation. Abdominal separation, normally you would get that after you have baby. You don't necessarily have to have had kids in order to get diastasis recti, okay? Now, for me personally, I had diastasis recti after I had my second child. So after I had my second, I experienced diastasis recti. I had no idea what it was until I got referred to a PT, a physical therapist, and they helped me along my journey to figure out how to, you know, deal with my DR. So that's the first time I've heard of DR, was after I had my second child. When I had my third child, that's when I really went deeper into finding out more information about diastasis recti, how to gain more, I guess, knowledge, how to gain more knowledge about DR and how to fix it. A lot of the times when I was looking into DR, or like when I would post on my stomach and people were saying, hey, Sam, I think you have a hernia, I think you have this, I think you have that. A lot of people were telling me that the only way I could heal my diastasis recti was through surgery. So surgery is not something that I want to do or ever, I don't even have that cross my mind. So I'm not planning on getting any surgery whatsoever. So I pushed surgery to the side and I just tried to focus on how I can strengthen and, you know, fix my DR naturally. So that's when I started diving deeper into learning more, gaining more information about it, and finding people who had a lot more knowledge in that field. After I had Cora, my stomach did not go back to how it was, obviously, because I had DR. And it took a while. It took some time for my stomach to, you know, lose that baby weight. But I still, like I said, I had that mom pooch because of the DR, and I was at like five finger gap. It was like crazy. A couple months ago, back in June, you guys know I was moving and all that stuff, so I'm just trying to do this timeline of telling you guys what exactly happened. So you guys know I was going through my move, and before that I was like working on core exercises, but after I started doing like my move and everything, and I was moving to California, you guys know, I fell off on exercises. But it wasn't until I got into the hotel in June, and I started doing core exercises. And I followed this woman, her name, I don't know her name, but her Instagram page is Our Fit Family. I think Our Fit Family Life. I'm not sure if I'm saying it right, but I'll put it here. I actually purchased her guide, and her guide allowed me to see exercises that I had no idea that I could do. And the thing about it, from what I've learned, that I've gained information from, and I'll put everything that I've, like her guide and all that stuff, down in the description box if you guys are interested. Her guide really helped me a lot. It is a 3-month program where you do these exercises. Now, these exercises that I did for myself back in June were exercises that is outside of the like whole bird dog exercises, those common exercises that you have to do like for DR. I have some of those exercises on my page. It goes away from that and gives you a different perspective of exercises that you can do for your core. And those exercises, I had no idea I could do, and I didn't know it would benefit me a lot with my core and, you know, resolving the DR. She did give me a code for you guys to use if you guys want to save money. And I don't get no commission or anything off of it. I just asked for her for a code to help you guys if you guys are interested in trying out her program. Now, before I did this program, back when I was in Hawaii, I did Nancy Anderson's program, and you guys may be familiar with it because I did mention it in a few videos in my past videos. I mentioned it, but I did her guide, and that helped me a lot as well. I just went ahead and branched off into Our Fit Family Life, like her program kind of was similar to Nancy Anderson, but it's very different guide. And that guide actually allowed me to even use these exercises up until now. Like, I do use bits and pieces of Nancy Anderson's program and Our Fit Family and other knowledgeable people who actually have degrees behind their belt that know exactly what DR is and how to combat that. So I've actually learned from like all these different people, and I'll put them all in the description box because they helped me a lot when it came to like healing my diastasis recti, what to do. And I've learned like it's not about just about the gap. It's not about that. The importance of DR is the linea alba, to see the connective tissue that holds the abdominal muscles together, how strong that is. I was learning so much when it came to diastasis recti. It's not necessarily about the gap when it comes to diastasis recti. I've learned through them that the connective tissue in between that holds your abdominal muscles, that's what matters, like the strength of that. So if you guys are like clueless as to what I'm saying, you guys can look up these pages. They have like different pages, especially if you're on Instagram. I'm sure they're on like Google and all that good stuff. But if you have Instagram, I'll put their links down below. These are the pages that I've learned from, because there's so much knowledge out there, guys, for diastasis recti. It's not just about like, oh my gosh, there's nothing I could do, let's just go and do surgery. It's not like that at all. Like, I learned so much about what exactly I need to do for my core. And like I told you guys, in some of my workout videos, I was doing core progressions, which is like slow exercises. And it's crazy because a lot of us think we always have to look for exercises that are safe for our diastasis recti, but that's not necessarily it. You could probably do a whole bunch of exercises. It's just you being aware of your stomach, making sure that you're not doming, and making sure that you're not affecting your core area at all. And if you're experiencing pain, then those exercises may not be right for you for in that moment. But gradually, over time, once your core gains its strength, then you can do like certain exercises. For the longest time, I thought I couldn't do certain exercises because of my diastasis, and come to find out, I can do those exercises. It's just how I go about doing those exercises. Is it affecting my core in any way? Am I doming, or am I doing this for my core, and is it hindering me? For me, day-to-day activities, I've learned to pretty much be mindful of everything I do, especially like using the bathroom. I always try to do like my Kegels. I always try to, instead of getting up out of the bed like straight away, I always try to use my arm and push to the side. I always go sideways when I try to lift, get myself out of bed, or I pick up core, I bend my knees instead of like just grabbing her, because I know that's gonna affect my core. So I'm always aware of my activities of what I'm doing, making sure that my core isn't being affected where like, oh my gosh, I'm making my diastasis worse. So I'm doing those types of things daily. Diet changes, when it came to me like losing my weight, I know you guys can see like the difference between how I looked last month compared to now. I did stop eating bread. I did mention that like in one of the comments, I stopped eating bread. I was eating bread a lot, guys, and I had to cut back on that. And then I started eating salad again. I kind of, for a long time after I had kids, salad was not my thing. Before, I used to eat salad all the time before I had kids, and then after I had kids, I was like, salad is not I can't stomach salad. But now I've been going back and eating salad, and I'm starting to eat salad like for lunch. I've also been trying to limit my snacking, so that's another way I like lost weight. Another thing that helped me was I was using my postpartum cincher. I'll put a picture here of my cincher of me wearing it, but I wear this probably like throughout the day, and I take it off before I go to sleep. And the reason why I wear this, I know some people think, like, some people say you don't need that, which you don't need it at all, but I feel like I need it because I'm doing day-to-day tasks, especially with carrying Cora. I feel like I need like a splinter to help with hold my muscles together. So I've been wearing that throughout the day. I've been doing exercises and I'm using that cincher throughout the day to help with my stomach. Some days I don't use it. Sometimes when I'm working out, I do use it. You guys can see like in my videos, I do wear it. But yeah, I've been using that. And if you guys are interested in that, I'll put that also in the description box. So the workouts, and I know some of the questions that I did get in the, from when I posted the picture, was what workouts I do. I do follow some workouts from Mom's Fitness, I think that's the app, but you have to pay for the app. But I remember those exercises that I did, and I'll post, like I said, I'll post a description, a link for the workouts that I do. I kind of do my own workouts. I'm always brainstorming to see what workouts I'm going to do, like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, how I'm going to do my core exercises and things like that. So that's pretty much what I've been doing. I've also been running a lot more. I think I run every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Or at least I try to. It just depends. Sometimes I run and then I jump off and I do like squats, or like I do high knees or something, and get back on the treadmill. So I'm always doing like different exercises to work different muscle groups. Yeah, that's pretty much it on this video. I think I touched bases on everything in regards to diastasis recti. And if you guys have any more questions, please be sure to leave them in the comments, and I will make sure that I answer it the best that I can. If you guys are interested in the RFit family, like the program that I'm still doing, like I said, I still do that program actually. She has a ton of pelvic exercises and a lot of core exercises to do for your diastasis recti on her page. So I'll put her link in the description box. So there's a lot of information out there. You just gotta search. But I hope you guys learned something in this video. If you guys are struggling with DR, let me know in the comments how that's going for you. If you did have like surgery for your diastasis recti, how is that going for you? Because I'm always like wondering how it is for those who do have surgery. Like, I obviously go back to normal, but is your core like still the same? I don't know. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in the next one. All right, bye guys.